Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I'm gonna create this makeup look which I pretty much wear every single day before I sit down to film YouTube videos. And I haven't done a makeup tutorial in so long now, so I thought of sitting down and talk to you guys and share the products I use and what product I used to use and what products I am loving currently. And also, since I have not done any makeup tutorial in a long time now, this video is going to be a little bit longer than usual because I am going to be explaining a lot of the things that I used to use right now, and all the products and stuff and all the stuff. So this video may go a little bit longer than usual. So yeah, I don't want to waste any more time, and if you'd like to see how I get this makeup look, and also this makeup is absolutely no foundation makeup tutorial. I have not used any foundation to create this look. So yeah, if you'd like to see this tutorial, then please keep on watching. Okay, so I already did my moisturizer and I also did my brows a little bit. I am yet to touch up my brows and also set my brows, which I'm gonna do later. But now let's move on to the primer. And the primer I'm using is from Wet n Wild, and it's their Cover All Primer. I really like this primer, and I try to put on primer whether or not I'm using a full face of foundation or not. Now time for some concealer. And for my concealer, when I'm not wearing any foundation on my face, I like Wet n Wild concealer, and this is a really nice concealer. And I use the shade medium deep tan when I'm not wearing any makeup. And I also like to use the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Cool Tan just to correct under my eyes. And I like to use the Pro Concealer whether or not I'm doing full face of makeup, so this one is the standard. But when I'm not doing any full face of foundation, I like to use the Wet n Wild Concealer. And just to highlight the center of my face, I either like to go with again the Wet n Wild Concealer, and this one is in the shade Medium Tawny, or I like the NYX HD concealer. This one is in the shade Fresh Beige. These three are my like very holy grail concealers in the drugstore, so I really like this. So I'm gonna first use the Cool Tan from LA Girl, and the shade Cool Tan has that apricot undertone to it, which instantly corrects and brightens up the area, which I really like. And I also like to apply just outside the eyes because I have a lot of veins showing through there, and I'm going to use my fingers to blend it. And now I'm going to use a little bit of the Wet n Wild Autofocus in medium deep tan. So yeah, this is the medium deep tan to further hide the dark circles. This is not for highlighting purpose, just to cover the dark circles. You see, my face already started looking a lot more fresh and a lot more awake. And now I'm gonna use the Wet n Wild concealer again, and this one is in the shade Medium Tawny. And this concealers I cannot use when I am doing full face of makeup because I like to match my foundations with my neck and my chest, and my neck and chest are lighter than my face. So just to get that one surface, I like to match my foundation with my neck and chest. So if I try to use this concealers on top of the foundation, it does not give any highlighting effect. It just conceals those areas. So I wanted to mention that. So I'm using the medium tawny from Wet n Wild, just a little bit. And I'm going to use the same concealer on the bridge of my nose, like on this area, and forehead, this, little bit this, not very much. And then I'm going to use my sponge to blend it all in. And this time I'm going to take the same sponge and go over the entire eyelid just to prep the eyelids at the same time. And now I'm gonna take the sponge and go all over the face. Okay, so the concealer is done now. And to set this concealer, I'm gonna be using the Miss Clair Blooming Face Powder. I did not know this, that Blooming Face Powder from Miss Clair has like two versions of it. I earlier used to think the Blooming Face Powder is the pearl one, and the translucent one are called as Translucent Face Powder. But then when I was taking the shot for my Blooming Face Powder Pearl review, I realized that Blooming Face Powder from Miss Claire are of two types. So that's why I just thought to mention this in the video as well. And the shade I'm using is 02. Now I'm gonna take the powder into this little sponge from PAC Cosmetics. Instead of taking into the damp sponge, I'm just gonna press it onto the powder directly and just press it under the eyes. I have a dry skin, and if I use the damp sponge, the powder mattifies a lot more than using the dry sponge. So that's why I'm using with this puff. Instantly, I'm gonna take the brush and just fluff off the excess powder, and at the same time, I'm gonna use the same brush just to powder up the rest of the face. Earlier, I used to use the Miss Claire translucent Blooming Face Powder all the time, and I just kind of forgot it in between. And right now I'm testing this product all over again, so I'm gonna have the review up onto it really soon. All right, so this is the time I will correct my eyebrows and just perfect it. So I'm going in with my spoolie first. And the eyebrow product that I am currently using and also really enjoying is from, it's a brow powder, and it's from Freedom Professional, and this one is their duo brow powder in the shade dark brown. So yep, I'm just gonna take that darker color and I'm gonna fill in the outer portion very slightly, and then taking the lighter one just to enhance the inner portion, and then just brushing it up. And then I'm gonna set it using a clear brow gel. This one is from Great Lash, and this is not really clear anymore. And right now I'm gonna move on to the eyes. And for my eyes, I just used the NYX Lid Lingerie, and I am in love. Previous to that, I used to use the e.l.f. palette, and this is not really easily available in India. You can get the e.l.f. palette on Amazon, but the price is really hiked up. I got mine from US, so yeah, and this is a really old one. This one is called as Matte for Matte, and on the inside, it looks like this. I still love this palette, but I also really like the lid lingerie from NYX Cosmetics, and I wanted to give you guys the option which is more easily available in India. So that's why in today's video I'm gonna be using the lid lingerie from NYX. So first I'm gonna take this color from the palette, the plain white color, and use that in my brow bone. And by the way, these are very pigmented, so I really love this. And next color from the palette I'm gonna take is this color right here, and I'm gonna just fluff that all over my lid just as a first transition. Okay, once that color is down, I'm gonna take this color from the palette, which is more on the rustic brown color, and just put that in the crease. And also I'm gonna concentrate that same color in the outer corner. And this eye look is all about what I am doing into the eyes and what sort of color I am doing. Does not matter what palette I am using, but it all matters which sort of color that I'm using to create the eye look. So yeah, and now I'm gonna go back to my first brush with no excess product and just blend the edges. Before filming the videos, I do not really put any shimmers onto my eyes, but if I have to for certain videos, I'm gonna share with you what I put, because I like it this way mostly, but sometimes I also feel like putting some shimmers onto my eyes, so I do that. And before I go to the shimmers, I'm gonna take the same transition color and put that underneath the eyes, and then I'm gonna blend the lower lash line color. And if I have to put shimmer colors, I would either like to use the highlighting powder from Wet n Wild, and it's their Crown of My Canopy, or I really like the City Mini palette from Maybelline, and it's their rooftop bronzers, and I already did a review onto all these palettes on my channel. So if you guys have not checked that video yet, I will have the link in the description box below for you guys. So I like to take this color from the palette, or this color. I basically like all the color from the palette, and I put that really gently on all over my lid, and it looks really beautiful onto the eyes. And today I'm gonna be using the Maybelline rooftop bronzers, and I'm gonna use mixture of this color and this color. I'm gonna first put this color on my lid and then gonna top it up with this color in the center. In fact, I'm gonna just do it in the inner third portion, and I'm gonna quickly go back to my original crease brush and blend it really well. And for the inner corners, I always like to use the Maybelline Master Chrome highlighter, and I also did a review onto this highlighter. Do check it out. And I'm just gonna put that in my inner corners. Alright, so I did my other eye off camera, and honestly, the shimmers are so subtle that it cannot even detect it on the eyes unless you look really closely, and that's how I like it to be. I just like to get the transition on point and the inner corners, and the mascara, of course. And for my mascara, of course, I like the Lash Sensation mascara, and I have refound my love for the Lash Sensational one while I was testing the Big Shot mascara from Maybelline, and I realized that I like this mascara way more than anything else. And this mascara is a really, really good mascara. And not for every video I use the Lash Sensational mascara, but I do have other mascaras which I really like as well. But I thought of sharing this mascara, and also encourage you guys to check my other video I did with the Big Shot Volume Express mascara, because this mascara does an insane job onto your lashes. So yeah. And the other mascaras that I really like to wear in my videos, again from Maybelline, they're let me show you Hyper Curl Volume Express mascara. I also like the one from Essence, and it's their I Love Extreme Volume mascara. Just do check my top 5 mascaras and you will know what mascaras I really like. So yeah, just do check that video. Alright, so now that we're done with the eyes, I'm gonna straight move on to the face, and I'm not gonna waste a lot of time with the face and the lips, because when I do full face of makeup with the foundation on, I like to use the Maybelline Master Contour palette, because this is a really pigmented palette as well as also very dark. But if I use this color when I am not wearing a lot of makeup, not at least the foundation, this looks a little bit very dark and very harsh onto the face. So that's why I like to use the Sugar Contour the Force palette, and this one is in the shade Vivid Victory, and I like to use this palette when I'm not wearing the foundation. And the color is really great for everyday use. And that is pretty much it for the contouring, and I'm gonna quickly do the blush as well. And for the blush, I really am loving the PAC Cosmetics powder blusher in number 5. It's a really nice nudie peach pink brown color and looks really natural onto the skin, so that's why I like this one. And okay, so now I'm left with the lips as well as highlighter. For my highlighter, I absolutely love the Maybelline Master Chrome highlighter, and this is a really beautiful color. And since this is very pigmented, I like to go very light-handed onto it and just put it on my cheekbones. And for the lips, I have different lip combos that I like to wear, and you guys always seem to ask me what lipstick I'm wearing, and the one I am really loving is from the NYX combo, and both are their soft matte lip creams. I have the shade Rome and the Berlin. I mix this together, and a lot of you guys always comment and ask me what lip combo I'm wearing. First, I'm going in with the Rome. The color is almost over, honestly. I like it so much. Shade Rome itself is a really pretty color, but this color is a little bit too pink for my liking, so that's why I like to mix in the shade Berlin, which is more on the brown sort of color. And this is the color that I get mixing Rome and Berlin together. And yeah guys, that is pretty much it for today's video. I really hope you guys have learned something from this video and maybe found this video helpful in some way. And if you did any of it, please give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And I will see you guys in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye.